And now a little bit about future. What will happen as a result? We know that officials, Kremlin, and not only them, even many from opposition, were not prepared at all to this development. And as you know, at the 4th of March we'll have election in Russia, presidential election. We know well that it's a real battle, and there is no doubt that even Putin really fights strong for presidential chair, definitely having a lot of resources, a lot of mass media under control, a lot of people who serve him, and he really need at the first time to prove that he is leader. Officials try to convince us, saying that, okay, you think that Putin is a bad guy? Maybe, but who is better? Who is able to take power? First of all, it's absolutely hypocritical, because everything what existing regime tried to make for the last decade, it just completely destroyed any opposition. No chance for any opposition to survive. And on the other hand, it's absolutely clear, if you today try to analyze who is the most logical in presentation of political position in Russia, and you will be surprised that it's Zyuganov. It does not matter that I don't like what he present. It doesn't matter that I opposite what he present. But he's the most logical, and it's clear absolutely why. Because he has ideology behind of him. And all leaders of opposition, including so popular Navalny, for example, they don't have any ideologies. They try to present immediately the program. But the program, it means kilometers, it means tons, it means money. But what does mean future? No program, never program give answer to that question. And it's absolutely clear that there is not a problem of absence of leader in opposition. The problem is absence of ideology. Clear ideology. Definitely yes. But as far as personally I know him, I understand his basic targets, which he want to reach, and definitely, again, I want to stress that he is the best from the other candidates, because he is really has experience. He understands mistakes which we have done. He understands mistakes which have done existing power. That question, I think it's logical to continue. I'm sorry, instead of you, is he project of Kremlin or not? Does he have any chance to win? And the answer is, unfortunately, he has a project of Kremlin, and he doesn't have any chance to win. In letter addressed to candidates, including Prokhorov, I just try to present them that they are criminal, unfortunately, yeah? I mean, criminal, Prokhorov is criminal, Zyuganov is criminal, Mironov is criminal, and Zhirinovsky is criminal. Because participation in so-called election is illegal, because Putin does not have power to go to the third term. If candidates to presidential power, I mean for men, took a decision not to participate in election, Putin was not able to go to election. Because again, maybe he said, okay, it doesn't matter, the Constitution does not allow to go just alone. It could be. But it means that each of them responsible for criminal events, each of them is part of criminal technology. It means that each of them is criminal. And they are simply able to stop this criminal event. Russia needs the same democracy like in this country, for example,